All right, so coming out the flip lane, the first thing I saw was a see one of my favorite gals checking in Hertz vehicles. I forget her name, but I really dig her. I'll be super careful. I got a lot of people walking around me right now. And this is in a pretty tight little spot. Oh man, I'm backing up trying to make space to get this out, and an up-down crew just showed up. So the space that I had to the left isn't there. The space that I had to the left to pull out through, which was pretty tight, isn't there because the cars that were at the front of that space have up-down drivers in them and they're backing out. So that's fine. I'm just going to patiently wait for them to get out of my way. So as I was saying, directly out of the flip lane, first thing I saw was a Ford Explorer that of course has a safety hold, because as I said, these things have a whole new recall on them. 2.5 weeks since fixing the last recall, we got a new recall on these things that has no fix for them. Already touched base with Chris about these and what we're doing with them. I did have to move one vehicle out of my way to make a gap to get out, and if I'd known the up-down crew was going to show up so quick, I wouldn't have even done that. Moved that Mazda for nothing. By the time I got back in this, they were rearranged stuff, but that just kind of is what it is. So instead of stacking these in the back lot where we had them last time, they've got an area over where they do fleet vehicles, like new vehicles that are coming in. It's going over there. So that's a good thing. It's a much shorter drive, and hopefully we'll get a fix from Ford on these soon. And when it's time to move them back to the shop, it'll be a lot less time consuming to move them back to the shop, and we can knock it all out in just a little bit of time versus it being an all week long chore. Oh, go me. Who the hell is beeping? Wow, somebody just set off the alarm in a car in the dirty line to my left. Some up-down driver. I don't know how the hell he did that, but do you hear it? That driver looks so awkward and embarrassed, and Jesse's walking up to him. Oh, man. I'm glad I've never done that. If I ever did, I would be so freaking embarrassed. Room for one more in the line I'm in. Even though I don't know how long these are going to be here, I still like to crack the window a little bit. And just having the windows 100% closed just seems to be a formula for a stuffy, nasty car. All right, let's go for a walk, shall we? So yeah, this is where they're going now. It's marked safety. I don't really need to mark no fix on it. It's a pretty much known thing with all the maintenance guys. But this is a no fix situation. So I think I just finished the second row of these. Yeah, we got a space here, and these vehicles off to the left. Not sure what these are. They're all Ford Escapes. I don't know what's up with the Ford Escapes. I'm not dealing with the Ford Escapes. I'm dealing with these Ford Explorers. So I just finished the second line. There's a third line and a fourth line already started. And in the front of the third line, I see some twit left the lights on. I try to be the guy who pays attention to these little things and fixes them when I can. Yep, headlights are on instead of auto. Other than that, the car does look shut off. So the lights switched over to auto. They should turn themselves off in due time. Whew. Well, this is an odd place to end up. And from here, I'm just gonna walk and find myself a clean to take up to the flip ramp and go back to walking through all those Hertz returns, see if I can find another maintenance car that needs to come this way. Or maybe another one of those recalled Ford Explorers. Damn, Ford Explorers. I just took one of those up to the flip ramp a little bit ago. Literally just driving to the nearest available gas-powered vehicle that's going out. Key left in vehicle. Yeah, that's how we do it. This one's a Chevy Suburban. Okay to service. Tag looks good. It's got a barcode on it. Stereo's coming on to channel 8, 80s at 8, Sirius XM, playing Minute Work Down Under. Nothing to fix there. I just got to turn that up. Rear howler coming on. That's no good. Do I remember how to turn it off in this? There's a button that says rear on off. Just hit that. Good to go. Seat's in a good position. Seat belt on. Colin Hay serenading me as I drive it up. I feel like Colin Hay is a really underrated musician. He's a lead singer, primary songwriter for Minute Work, but he's got a really substantial solo discography that most Americans know nothing about. I do believe he stayed fairly popular in the land down under. If you've never listened to them before, or you don't own them, the first 2 Minute Work albums are amazingly good, especially the first one, Business as Usual. But the second one, Cargo, really enjoyed that as well. Their third album, I forget the name of it. It's got like an image of somebody diving into a pool. I remember I owned it at one point in time and I've listened to it a few times, but I don't recall ever really getting into that record. Which isn't to say if I wasn't to listen to it now, I wouldn't get into it. But just share. Oh! Hey, it's Phil Collins with the song Studio, which is something he recorded in his studio. Oh, wow.
What the hell?
So, the dash just said Cadillac Q. Oh, it's got a weird power seat. What the hell is that button? That's weird. On the outside, I totally thought that this was a Chevy Malibu. Oh no, it's most definitely a Cadillac CTS. But it is shaped, especially on the inside, disturbingly, like a Chevy Malibu. Well, I just got an ass twitching from this thing. Oh, it's twitching my ass again. It feels I'm too close to the car behind me. Oh, I got a whole crew of up-down drivers. I think I'm just gonna wait for them to get out of my way, rather than try to do a tricky maneuver to get out of here. What's up?
Can I see that key?
The key?
So, I know this shop car, but we needed this one.
Oh, no problem. Well, that was super awkward, and I really wish I'd have left before he walked up, because the awkward is not over with this car. So, I'm not sure who that guy was. I don't really know him, but he's obviously a Hertz, either a low-level manager or a customer service rep, but he says that a renter needs this and is waiting for this. It was flagged as oil change on the window. Although I don't see anything popping up on the screen that says it needs an oil change. Anyway, he already scratched the windows clear and asked me to take it down to the car wash and ask them to clean it immediately, that it needs to go back up to a renter. So I might hang tight with it just to make sure it's done. I prefer to, when this happens and they ask me to handle this, I prefer to give it to a car washer that I know that actually speaks English. But that's not something that's always an option here. Well, that was an interesting change of path. So yeah, I brought the Cadillac down. Talked to my favorite car washer, because he seems to be the only one who speaks English down there with a local accent. And I know, like, I'm not going to have any communications issues with him. But he seemed a little bit thrown. He's like, well, usually a Hertz lead will tell me to do that. He goes, why are you not an MLS driver? Why are you telling me that? And I'm like, I swear, a Hertz lead told me to do it. I said, he scraped the paint off. He's doing what he's busy right now, trying to get it out of the system for maintenance. Come on, man, you know me. I wouldn't jack you around like that. He's like, well, okay, I'll get it done. And I put the flashers on, because that's something that we generally do to signify that a car is reserved like that. But anyway, yeah, I did like three runs of just quick up downs by myself. Got to drive a Toyota CHR down. That's a vehicle I was talking about maybe about a week ago that kind of had this little tiny, it's like a subcompact and has sort of an alien spacecraft look. And I really dig those. Even though it sort of has, I don't know, I can't really say why I like those so much, but I guess they're odd and small and drive really well, and of course they're Toyotas, so there's that. Or wait, no, Hondas. Sorry, Honda. Or is it a Toyota? Now I'm not sure. Anyway, drove one of those down. But yeah, I kept going there and then checking to see the progress of the Cadillac. And the last time I just now came down, the Cadillac was gone. And I was like, oh shit. And then I noticed that the manager lead or whatever he is, and it's not somebody I'm familiar with, but obviously he's somebody of higher importance, because he was rolling with a walkie-talkie and he was talking to somebody about the car, and it kind of, you know, rushed up on me to try to get me to see what I could do to get that car turned around and out to a specific renter as quickly as possible. But yeah, he was down at the car wash and he saw me walk up and just thanked me, very energetically thanked me for handling that. And that was a really positive kind of experience. It's those kind of things that I do on the regular that, generally speaking, MLS drivers don't mess with, that I think at some point might land me with a better job working directly for Hertz. Although I love the job that I do right now, I don't think I'd be as happy just standing around doing computer stuff as I am just rolling cars all over the place and checking things on the cars. And I like the fact that I never know, you know, what I'm driving next and where I'm driving next. By the way, moving another one of my last chip cars over to the Dollar Car Wash. There's Anthony. He just waved at me. He's talking on the phone. He waved. It's always good when the leads see me and they just see that I'm working and they just smile and wave. That's always a good sign. It's funny how sometimes I'll just go days without anybody really giving me direction or saying anything to me, but just, you know, the smile and wave like I just got. Just got that Malibu over by the car wash. Although Meyer had asked me to if I got down here to bring some clean dollar cars over to the flip ramp. I only see two dollar cars over there. And honestly, it's a shorter walk up the stairs to the one car I have over in Dollar Maintenance. So maybe I'd just rather do this walk and get over there and get that handled. Plus my buddy's working over there tonight, so I won't say hi to her again. Wow, two Chevy Malibus in a row. I didn't notice that when I was driving by, that it was a Chevy Malibu waiting over here in the Dollar Maintenance line. I just kind of noticed it was a car and moved forward. You know, sometimes I notice details about stuff, like I'll be noticing so many details more than other people notice. And other times, all I register is, oh, there's a car there, and that's it. And the reason I mentioned that, I got my seat adjusted, let me get some tunes on up in here. Ooh. That is such a tease. 105 on SiriusXM still comes up and says Billy Joel channel, and it still shows in the presets as Billy Joel channel, but as of the first, it's no longer the Billy Joel channel, which is frustrating because all it's playing is SiriusXM preview. Yeah. Anyway, I just use the shortcut preset button on the back side of the steering wheel to flip over to classic vinyl. James Gang, Walk Away. Early Joe Walsh. You know, for the longest time, I never realized that Joe Walsh was the lead singer of James Gang. I always thought he sounded like Joe Walsh, but I didn't realize it actually was Joe Walsh. Pretty sure I got this album on vinyl at home. Hey, look, Winolo's offering me a gig right now. Probably Factor for tonight. It offered me that earlier when I was sitting with Steve. As Steve was getting a talking to from, I don't know if it was, the female manager. I can never remember her name. Monique. Yeah, he kind of got a talking to from Monique, and then he called up Rob and talking to Rob on speakerphone. That was super awkward for me. Well, I never really noticed how, when I'm coming down the Hertz ramp, that if I look straight off in the distance, I can see the neon on SkyTrain 24th Street Station. That's pretty cool. Didn't see anybody working on the supercharger installation today. That project seems like it's going so slow. Oh my goodness. I haven't been down on the maintenance yard in a while. It's 6:44 right now. Still a good hour-ish of bringing cars to them. And, they emptied a lot out of here. The career of Joe Walsh, who brought Rockaway with him to the Eagles, and will probably be playing it tonight in Charlotte and Thursday in Raleigh. If you go, have a good show. Earl Bailey with a good show going.
16:75 an hour, Goodyear, 7 p.m. Wednesday, 8th of November, Factor.
And let's go with Badcock.
It's 6:45. I don't understand why Winolo puts out gigs. It's 6:45 where you have to be there at 7. Why do they even bother? Because if you show up late, you get strikes from Winolo. It's just nonsensical. Like, I get it, they still need that shift filled, but at this point, they should be putting it in with a start time of 8 o'clock. That way people can look at that and go, yeah, maybe I could do that. As opposed to look at that and going, no, I don't want to strike from Winolo, and I can't get there in 15 minutes. Oh, it just immediately started blowing and making noise at me, and it didn't start. Let's try this again. All right, there we go. So this is a Subaru Crosstech. These things are freaking ugly. it's got a weird looking instrument cluster. Like all the lights and all the gauges are like a dim red. I don't know if that's user adjustable or not. I probably don't have time to mess. Don't have time to mess with it and figure that out. If there's a way to make the gauges brighter though. Oh, there's a dimmer and it's as bright as it goes. Wow, those are some really odd looking gauges. Let me bring this up so y'all can see that. So those are really, really odd looking gauges to me. Do I have music? I do. Let's get going. Hmm. That's odd. I have headlights on. There's no lights down on the shifter to show me what gear I'm putting it into. I got a D in my little display though between the gauges, so I know I'm in drive. Alright, I don't know what's on the radio, but I'm not feeling that at all. No shoes, one more night, slightly stupid, country. When did slightly stupid become a country band? So many country stations on SXM, and most of them I could give a shit about. All right, Studio 54. Generally speaking, it's a disco station, but Gap Band? Yes, please. Oh, this is one of my last two going from the glass chip area over to the Dollar Car Wash, by the way. That ramp a little quicker than normal. I got the van right behind me. Good time. You dropped a bomb on me, baby. Van turned left, headed towards Gold and Ultimate. Not empty, but it's slim pickings over there. Nothing in dollar maintenance. Well, seeing how empty PC is and seeing that dollar maintenance is empty, even if there's only one vehicle down here in the cleans, I'm gonna be taking it over. Somewhere it hurts. The angry elf is working tonight, so I'm really not messing much with electrics. Poindexter's working, I'm always down to help him, but the angry elf is, no, not so much. Wow, somebody coming up from Dollar with their headlights off. I don't know why it's so hard for other people to turn their dang headlights on. But three vehicles out in the cleans here. Ow. So of those three vehicles, the one closest to me turned out to be a Ford Explorer. I don't know, I just can't with good conscience bring that one up. Pretty damn sure that's supposed to have a safety hold on it. Got a Kia Soul or a Kia Niro. Oh, I'm not messing with EVs, so we'll get the Soul. All the lights are on. I'm not sure if the car's still running or not. These are so quiet. Oh yeah, it's on. It's running. Radio is off. This probably has a HD radio tuner. Yes, but the HD radio is turned off. Why? I love when they have presets set for static. Delete. Delete.
FS$8 too.
94.5.
Meet UHC. That's 1-855 Meet UHC. Annual enrollment begins October 15th and ends December 7th, so call today.
Get big savings and big. Usually it's pretty obvious when the HD radio kicks in, but I didn't really hear the jump then. Anyway, KWSS HD. Didn't take too long to tune that in. This one's got 19,000 miles on it. It's a Kia Soul. Looks like a newer one. All digital dashboard on it. This could go in several different categories at Hertz, so I'm just going to take it to the flip ramp and let somebody else worry about sorting it. And then see what I got for maintenance over there. That's got like a very like Indian Middle Eastern kind of sound to it. I have no idea what they're playing. Half the time on KWSS, I don't know what they're playing. And that's why I like the station so much. Driving around over in the dollar sign with their headlights off. Just realized my left mirror's flipped in. Oh, and so is my right. Maybe I'll get a content match on this song and then I'll know what the hell it is. That is such a great hook. HD radio is actually capable of showing cover art along with the artist and title of songs as they play. Unfortunately, KWSS HD isn't configured to do that. It just says KWSS 93.9-99.5.
A reminder to you all that this organization will not tolerate failure.
KWSS 93.9 and 99.5 FM.
And also 94.5 FM HD2. They hardly ever say that.